This is ABC7 News at 11, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Good evening, I'm Haley Wilkes. Thank you for joining us tonight. We're going to get right over to Bob this evening and get an update on what has been a very active day in the Weather Center.
That's right, Haley. It has been an active day. Right now, we're looking at the satellite imagery of what was like this evening. The system itself was over land and then eventually pushing off toward the east. Now, we are looking at basically a system that developed very rapidly overnight and then pushed off toward the east. Right now, the latest on Emily now, which is down to 30-mile-an-hour storm, so it has weakened considerably, that it's been overland. So Florida has done its part in diminishing the intensity of this storm as it has made its way over land. The fuel source no longer available for this system at this point, and that's good news. It appears that it's not going to strengthen once it moves into the Gulf too much. The movement is at the east at 9. The pressure has come up now at 1,010 millibars, and skies are starting to clear behind it. Although there's a little bit of a line of shower activity there and some very heavy rainfall down to our south. You'll see that on the radar imagery in just a little bit. The tropical storm warnings have all been discontinued, obviously, for the state. There are small craft advisories in effect along the east coast. There's not much here to the west, and there's the forecast path and track. It just stays as a low pressure system as it makes its way out into the open waters of the Atlantic. So good news on that front. Now the radar picture is still showing a little bit of a rotation. It's a broad area of low pressure, really. You can see the showers and storms moving off to the southwest here and these moving off to the east. And this is a very large area of low pressure which continues to move away. But the big storms are down to our south now near Naples and south of Fort Myers. Not a lot going on here. There were a few showers, brief showers that were around earlier, and then the heavier storms offshore. We'll have to keep an eye on those ones offshore. But more than likely, they're going to continue to move off toward South Florida. As far as the dry air is concerned, it is moving in. So this is going to have an impact on our weather on Tuesday. It'll give us a chance to dry out a little bit after excessive amounts of rainfall, nearing 5 inches today across parts of the Suncoast. We'll have more on this and the tropics coming up in just a few minutes. Haley.
Thank you, Bob. A group of apartment buildings in one Bradenton development experienced a lot of roof and ceiling damage from Tropical Storm Emily. The apartments that were affected are in the Oakmead apartment complex. That's in the 1800 block of 13th Avenue East. ABC7's Rick Adams takes a closer look at some of the damage.
Well, this storm affected four apartment buildings here. Back there is one of the buildings that was damaged. This has caused some major headaches for quite a few folks around here.
This is what the inside of Jonas Lammy's Bradenton apartment looks like. Heavy wind and rain from Tropical Storm Emily damaged the roofs and ceilings of the buildings, including the second floor apartment where Lammy stays with his family.
The water can, is loose. And then he can down and they flow.
Lammy tells us his mother did suffer minor injuries. No other injuries were reported. The four buildings damaged were in the process of being re-roofed. Work crews spent their Monday afternoon putting up blue tarps to prevent further damage and drying out the units.
We've got three units that had some of their ceiling or part of their ceiling come down in the unit. We also have the other units are on the second floors. All were affected.
Thomas Buck has lived at the Oakmead Apartments with his wife and four children for a year. Although his first floor apartment wasn't damaged, he's upset that this happened to a lot of his neighbors.
I'm sad. They lost a lot of property, a lot of personal items, and you know it's low-income housing, and some of them couldn't afford renter's insurance, so all their personal property that got damaged, how are they going to get reimbursed for that?
It's a problem Buck says could have been avoided because the contractor was working on many buildings at once instead of just focusing on one building.
As far as doing one building at a time, that's mainly what our concern was, and it ended up being catastrophic.
The Red Cross was on scene helping those folks who were affected.
And Bradenton's fire marshal says the repairs to these buildings should be finished within the next couple of days. Reporting from Bradenton, I'm Rick Adams, ABC7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Rick. The city of Bradenton hit hard by the storm. Northwest Bradenton and parts of Palmetto were under a tornado warning during today's storm. For about 5 minutes, hundreds of homes were without power as trees and branches hit lines and other Florida power and light equipment in that area. FPL reporting more than 600 power outages and other issues. Geraldine's Farm Market had the metal roof peeled back by wind gusts, and nearby Orban's Nursery watched their 40-year-old warehouse collapse at the massive roof that was lifted off of the building and crashed back down in a different position. The storm making landfall on Anna Maria Island, bringing heavy rain and strong winds to that area. The storm also leaving behind flooded roadways, power outages, and scattered debris in the area. The Manatee County Sheriff taking to Twitter, warning residents to avoid the island if at all possible earlier today. And for those who were already there, they had to make their way through those flooded streets.
We saw a couple cars that were actually stuck. We had breakfast farther down on the island today, and one of the parking lots, 2 or 3 feet of water, and there were a couple of cars that were stuck there.
Some businesses and residents lost power all day, but that has since been restored. City of Venice officials say there was no severe damage or flooding in their area. Officials did say today's storm was a good test run for their emergency response plans. The South Jetty Park walkway was closed this morning due to waves crashing all over the jetty. The downtown fountains were also closed. And then at Sharkey's on the pier, the storm largely caught them by surprise as well. As a Gulf-fronted business, they had to be secure, make sure to secure all of their furniture as those winds began to pick up.
We're always trying to be prepared for this time of year for hurricane season, so we start the season like that, but there's always something we miss, and this is a good reminder to always be ready.
The South Jetty Walkway has now been reopened to the public. Hundreds of businesses and homes remain without power in Manatee and Sarasota counties. Most of those are in Manatee County, where more than 500 buildings are without power, according to Florida Power and Light. Only a few dozen in Sarasota County without electricity at this hour. And Sarasota County will no longer be handing out sandbags on Tuesday. The county announcing this evening that the plans have changed after reviewing Tuesday's expected rainfall and consulting with the National Weather Service. And do remember, you can get instant alerts on Tropical Storm Emily, which you really don't need at this point, but there will be possible other storms. We'll also probably have severe weather throughout the summer. Those alerts will be delivered straight to your phone. All you have to do is download the MySunCoast app. You will get some important news updates, weather forecasts, and traffic alerts on the go. In other news, an emergency rescue in Tampa Bay just before Tropical Storm Emily made landfall this morning. Two brothers from Tampa were fishing aboard their 17-foot boat when their engine died and the boat began taking on water. The boat drifted and hit a range light. The men called for help as the boat sank. A crew from St. Petersburg arrived at the scene within 20 minutes to rescue the brothers. The fishermen were taken to the station without any injuries. The Charlotte County Sheriff's Office is cracking down on suspects involved in crimes. Deputies recently conducted a field interview, which led to the closure of several car burglaries in the Deep Creek area. They focused the patrol on Thursday and Friday, resulted in 8 arrests for different charges. 3 men were arrested with possession of marijuana and drug paraphernalia. One woman was charged with tampering with evidence, and one convicted felon was charged with a burglary. Charlotte County deputies also responded to calls about a suspicious vehicle in Punta Gorda. Deputies noticed the door of a nearby home was standing open. They found Edward Hilton in the home's backyard. He fled the scene swimming across a nearby pond. Hilton barricaded himself in a shed where deputies found him. The suspicious vehicle was identified as Hilton's. He was arrested for burglary, theft, and violation of probation. New details on a deadly shooting in Sarasota. Police say a man accidentally shot his sister and is now facing a manslaughter charge. Police were called to a house on Arlington Street yesterday afternoon. They say 20-year-old Leticia Cortez was sitting with her family at the kitchen table when her brother, 19-year-old Daniel Cortez Reyes, pulled out a semi-automatic handgun. He told investigators he pulled the magazine out of the firearm, inserted the magazine again, and then the gun discharged. A single round struck his sister. She was taken to Sarasota Memorial Hospital, where she later died. At this time, investigators say they believe the shooting was accidental. All lanes on University Parkway's Diverging Diamond Interchange are officially open. The traffic pattern began operating in May with 10 lanes. The final 2 officially open today. The Florida Department of Transportation says this is the largest interchange of its kind in the U.S. It's already improving overall traffic flow. A landscaping project at that interchange will begin next year. Straight ahead, Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan will be back with the official Suncoast forecast. Plus, the new chief of staff just sworn in at the White House, and already there are shakeups within the administration. And could you soon be sitting in an even smaller seat when you fly? Not if certain groups have a say in the matter. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
At Tidewell Hospice, we know it's never too late to say thank you to our military veterans. The Tidewell Honors Veterans Program has provided care to more than 13,000 military families since 2008. Tidewell volunteers help honor veterans through special pinning ceremonies that demonstrate our appreciation for the freedom our veterans fought to defend. If you know a veteran who can benefit from end-of-life care, call or visit Tidewell.org today. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com, your guide to the foodie lifestyle. ABC7's own Chef Judy serves up her favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blog, step-by-step videos, and Suncoast Restaurant Guide. You'll find it all at MySuncoast.com/dining.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
This was not what we were expecting for this Monday.
Wow. I was in the thick of things, too, in Northwest Brayton. That's where
right
we live.
Right out in the middle of it,
and,
yeah.
And 73-mile-an-hour wind gusts. That's what we had. Wow. That's the graphic right there that you see. 73, you know, that's close to hurricane strength.
Wow, yeah.
And sustained winds are up around 45 to 50 miles an hour. Here's some of the damage. Mm. I had a chance to drive around and shoot some of this, and you can see that tree was just twisted right off. That sign, which was in a metal sign, stop sign, was bent over. This tree was uprooted, just narrowly missing that home. And that was a very large tree. This is a what's left of a trampoline. And there were several of these that were picked up and tossed about. Again, trees snapping power lines, causing power outages throughout Northwest Brayton, getting the worst damage of them all, as you can see right there. And there's that house that it just missed. And we talked about it earlier, some of the businesses there in Northwest Brayton sustaining some damage as a result of Tropical Storm Emily. And some viewer photos sent in too. This one, not only in Manatee, but Sarasota too. Jacaranda, Nancy Lancaster, showing a lot of trees down in her backyard and covering off some of the porch right there. So some big trees falling there as well. And this one from Northwest Bradenton. You see that large tree right there? Underneath it is a PT Cruiser, which was crushed right there. That's why we advise not to be driving around when these winds are blowing up to 50, 60 miles an hour. Jackie Van O sending that photo into that PT Cruiser underneath that large tree right there. Well, we had some sunshine finally later on in the afternoon as the system moved through. Then another little feeder band made his way through, bringing with it some showers and just a little glimmer of sunshine there as the storm continues to head off to the east. Weather headlines read like this: Emily weakening, continuing rain chance lowers on Tuesday, but it's back on Wednesday as more moisture returns. Now, the radar picture is depicting a lot of rainfall down to our south. I think we'll have an evening of less activity. Last night, some big thunder rolling through parts of the Suncoast. These storms are pushing off to the west. Basically, these are kind of feeding into a place further south than our region. And the system itself continues to move off to the east. So good news, it's now a tropical depression and looks as though it will stay that way. No rain depicted right now. We need a chance to dry out, too, after an excessive amount of rainfall today. Tropical downpour is bringing up to nearly 5 inches of rain at times, and still happening down near Naples. You can see that along Alligator Alley. Here's the rainfall totals as they have been coming in. Estimates 2.4 in Northport, Inglewood getting over 3 inches of rainfall. Right there at Bayshore Gardens, 4.5 inches, and at the airport, we had over 3 inches of rain in just a short period of time. But there's the dry air that just on the border of it now. There goes our system off into the Atlantic eventually by tomorrow, and some of this dry air will be in place, although we'll still see a few scattered showers and a few storms around. Skies are partly cloudy right now, 77 degrees. Dew point is at 73, and winds are out of the north northeast at 7. The pressure has been rising, 29.99 inches. Good sign there. The high today was below average, as you would expect, with the rain and clouds and showers. Our normal high at 90, or normal low into the mid-70s. Well, there are nearly 4 inches of rainfall at the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport today. That brings our monthly total well above the average. And as far as winds go, not nearly as windy tomorrow. It was a very windy day today, especially right around 11 o'clock this morning. Basically out of the west overnight and southwest on Wednesday. That brings moisture back into play again. And that front's still there. That front, as I said last week, sometimes sits out here in the Gulf and a little spin-up occurs. Well, we could see that again. We'll have to keep an eye on it out there in the Gulf, because it will be remaining in the Gulf of Mexico on Wednesday. It may not be as strong as it was today, but there goes the remnants of what was Emily. And for us, we'll start to see this moisture increasing with showers and storms in the offing, especially Wednesday afternoon. Well, for boating tomorrow, better. Still a bit breezy. A moderate chop on the bays and inland waters. As far as tides go, upcoming tide, low tide at 159. Sunset will be at 819 tomorrow. Partly cloudy. A few scattered showers, mainly offshore. It will be breezy, 78 tomorrow. 30% chance for storms, a high of 89. So a little bit less action tomorrow. But then it comes back pretty strong on Wednesday. And then by the weekend, it returns once again. Haley?
Thank you, Bob. Tonight, another shakeup within the Trump White House. New Chief of Staff General John Kelly immediately cleaning house. The White House announcing Communications Director Anthony Scaramucci would be already leaving his role. ABC's Megan Hughes has the details.
White House Chief of Staff John Kelly is charged with restoring order. Anthony Scaramucci, who was in the back of the room as Kelly was sworn in, was in the crosshairs.
I predict that General Kelly will go down in terms of the position of Chief of Staff, one of the great ever.
The controversial communications director, known as the Mooch, quickly made waves.
I love the president.
Attacking several senior White House officials in a tirade to the New Yorker, calling former Chief of Staff Reince Priebus a bleeping paranoid schizophrenic, and tearing into strategist Steve Bannon with a profane attack. His words went viral, his gestures mirroring the president's mocked on The Daily Show. The White House says the president, who's used some choice words himself in the past, wasn't pleased.
The president certainly felt that Anthony's comments were inappropriate for a person in that position.
White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders took over from Sean Spicer the same day Scaramucci was hired, now announcing a shift in the chain of command. Everyone, including the president's daughter and son-in-law, will now report to the chief of staff.
General Kelly has the full authority to operate within the White House, and all staff will report to him.
Scaramucci had made a point of saying he reported only to the president. President Trump tweeting late Monday, a great day at the White House. Megan Hughes, ABC News, Washington.
There could soon be a minimum space requirement for airline passengers. Aircraft seats and the space between them are getting smaller, and that could be considered a safety hazard. The U.S. Court of Appeals has ordered the FAA to take a closer look at the amount of space that passengers have on commercial planes. Seat width, that has decreased by about an inch and a half since the early 2000s, measuring about 17 inches. The space between seats has also decreased, going from an average of 35 inches to about 31, with some bargain airlines having just 28 inches of legroom.
It does not appear that people can get out with the smaller seats. Most recently, there was an evacuation for a burning engine in an aircraft, and it took about 5 minutes instead of 90 seconds.
Comfort is something the FAA does not look at, but they say they do consider it when testing and assessing the safe evacuation of an aircraft. They're now studying the ruling and any actions that would need to be taken to address the court's findings. Florida wildlife officials have less money this year to help communities with bear-proof trash containers. The Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission recently announced the start of a nearly three-month application period for local governments and others seeking bear-wise funding. The agency has $515,000 to match with local government funding to help residents and businesses buy these bear-resistant trash cans and hardware to secure regular trash cans and have modified dumpsters. That is down from $825,000 last year. Despite the drop, the FWC says the program should still be successful.
We won't have enough money as an agency to sponsor every single person who might want a can to have one, but we can get enough cans out there so that neighbors see it, they see that it works, and then the counties see it, and they can maybe require that as part of their contracts with waste service providers.
Roughly 4,000 black bears are estimated to live in Florida. The majority of the BearWise money will go to communities that have enacted ordinances requiring residents and businesses to keep garbage secure from bears who are looking for food. Sports is next, but first, here's Jimmy Kimmel.
Look what we can do when we apply ourselves. Will you sleep over someone's house if it seems like an appealing offer?
I might do that.
You might do that.
Credit card debt can ruin your life. If you owe $10,000 and minimum payments are siphoning away your paycheck each month, you can get debt-free in less time than you think.
I've paid $800 a month for the past 3 years and haven't changed the balance on my credit card.
Get Debt-Free Now has a program to reduce your debt, stop the harassing phone calls, avoid financial ruin, and settle for less than you owe.
I feel like a huge weight has been lifted off my shoulders.
You're pre-approved for our special hardship program if you owe $10,000 or more. Upon payment of your new lower balance, your debt will finally shrink until you are debt-free.
My family no longer has 30 years of payments ahead of us at 20% interest.
There's no fees until you see results. So call now. Make one monthly program payment and free up your cash. Resolve your debt.
Call 800-628-1251. 800-628-1251.
A decade of war has taken an unprecedented toll on our men and women in uniform.
Hundreds of thousands of our veterans are suffering from the trauma of war.
At Justice for Vets, we believe that every veteran should have the opportunity for treatment and restoration.
Get involved and go to justiceforvets.org.
Help put treatment within reach of veterans in crisis.
Veterans fought for our freedom. Now it's our turn to fight for theirs.
Download ABC7's all-new official Suncoast weather app onto all your devices so you can stay informed wherever you go. With our full-featured all-new weather app, you can get weather alerts, interactive radar maps, current conditions, 10-day forecasts, traffic maps, and weather video from ABC7, all at your fingertips. And it's free. ABC7's all-new official Suncoast weather app, sponsored by Mr. Sparky. Just search Suncoast WX in the App Store and download yours today.
Northland Outdoors is about so much more than the biggest fish or the hottest hunting spots. All across the Northland, there are amazing people with incredible stories to tell. We're going to find those stories and share them with everyone.
Join us each and every week as we explore the Northland and experience some of the most exciting outdoor adventures in the country right here in our own backyard. This is Northland Outdoors.
Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilgus, ABC7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community.
Check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com for Chef Judy's favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blogs, step-by-step videos, and Suncoast Restaurant Guide. You'll find it all at MySuncoast.com/dining. Now, sports.
Tonight in Houston, the Astros taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. We will pick it up in the bottom of the second. Astros have a 1-0 lead. Jose Altuve hits a single into right field, and two runs come in to score easily. Astros take a 3-0 lead. Top of the third, same score. Corey Dickerson batting with a runner on first. Dickerson swings and blasts one out to deep left. It is gone for a two-run homer, 3-2 Astros. Bottom of the third, Astros up by two. Jake Mariznick batting with two outs and runners on first and second. He sends one out to deep left field, and it is gone for a three-run blast. The Astros take a 7-2 lead. Right now, in the bottom of the eighth, the Astros are still in the lead, 13-6. The Tampa Bay Lightning players and staff are honoring a young fan from here in Sarasota. Sarasota High School senior Tony Colton died yesterday after his 7-year battle with cancer. He made the most of his life by following the Lightning and even got to play with some of the members on the team. Winger Ryan Callahan tweeting today, "Tony was a special kid. You will be greatly missed." And center Tyler Johnson posting, "Tony was a true inspiration and friend. The amount of courage you showed is incredible." Well, it is official. The Summer Olympics will return to the U.S., but not for another decade. Los Angeles has reached an agreement with international Olympic leaders, opening the way for the city to host the 2028 Summer Games. The pact is expected to be reviewed by the city council later this week. The deal would make L.A. a 3-time Olympic city after hosting the 1932 and 1984 games. This follows a vote earlier this month by the Olympic Committee to seek a deal to award the 2024 and 2028 games in Paris is seen as a favorite for 2024. Good to have them back here in the United States. That's a look at sports. We'll have our winning lotto numbers right after this.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
I knew I could get myself out of this. I just needed some hope and some help.
I took the first step to recovery when I made the call.
Since 2014, Addiction Hope and Helpline has answered calls for recovery and treatment 24/7, 365 days a year. If you're depressed, drinking, using drugs, or taking pills, call now and talk to someone who cares.
I had problems just getting to sleep, drinking and using pills every night.
I feel like I'm losing control. I'm afraid I'll lose my job or even my family.
Most insurance covers substance abuse. You can get back on track. Call now for hope and help with proven gentle recovery programs.
I never thought that I could be somebody who didn't drink and use drugs.
I have something to hold on to for strength. I'm in recovery, getting the help I need.
Call 800-622-1941. 800-622-1941.
Call to see if you qualify to enroll in a Medicare Advantage plan right now. At Humana, we believe great things are ahead of you when you start with healthy. And part of staying healthy means choosing the right Medicare plan. Humana can help. With Original Medicare, you're covered for hospital stays and doctor office visits when you're sick, but keep in mind, you'll have to pay a deductible for each. A Medicare supplement plan can cover your deductibles and coinsurance, but you may pay higher premiums than you do with other plans. And prescription drug coverage isn't included. But with an all-in-one Humana Medicare Advantage plan, you could get all that coverage plus Part D prescription drug benefits. All for an affordable monthly plan premium, and in some areas, no plan premium. It's all described in this free book and DVD. Call for yours and discover how an all-in-one Medicare Advantage plan from Humana could save you money. Call 1-844-328-2700.
I witnessed him have two heart attacks in ICU. He went through seizures.
We'd much rather have Aaron like this than dead. A lot of parents don't have that luxury.
He can't talk. He can't walk.
This is a condition Aaron will live with for the rest of his life because he abused prescription pills.
Mind your meds. Learn more from the Partnership for Drug-Free Kids.
The official Suncoast Hurricane Guide from ABC7. Download yours today.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
Auto Lottery winning numbers are sponsored by Frontier Fios.
Bob, I was thinking it was kind of like, be careful what you wish for, because we were saying how dry it was last week, right, and how we didn't get any showers to cool us off.
I was, I agree. We actually made it up really quick. The thing is that at least this was just a minimal tropical storm.
Right.
You know, it really gives you an idea how big a hurricane or even a major hurricane could be and what it could do to this area. So thankfully it was just a weak tropical storm.
And you said it's a great reminder, if you haven't had the, haven't made your kit, if you haven't made your emergency plan, now's the time to do it. See you tomorrow.